ప్రపన్న పారిజాతాయ తోత్ర వేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృత దుహే నమః. ఓం. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ ఎపిసోడ్ వి కన్క్లూడెడ్ ది 10th చాప్టర్ విచ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ ది విభూతి యోగ. దేర్ వి సా కృష్ణ టెలింగ్ టు అర్జున అబౌట్ వేరియస్ సే గ్లోరియస్ మేనిఫెస్టేషన్స్ ఆఫ్ ద డివైన్ అండ్ ఐ నీడ్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ టు దట్ అగైన్. హీ టోల్డ్ ఫర్ ఎ శాంపుల్, హీ గేవ్ ఎ ఫ్యూ ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్. ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ హీ గేవ్ అబౌట్ 75 ఎగ్జాంపుల్స్ అండ్ దెన్ హీ సెడ్ ఏష తు ఉద్దేశత ప్రోక్త. ఓన్లీ యాజ్ ఎ శాంపుల్ ఐ టోల్డ్ ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్, బట్ దెన్ దేర్ ఇస్ నో ఎండ్ నాంతోస్తి, దేర్ ఇస్ నో ఎండ్ టు మై విభూతీస్. సో దట్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఈ సెడ్. బికాస్ ఎనీ మేనిఫెస్టేషన్, ఎనీ గ్లోరియస్ మేనిఫెస్టేషన్, వెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ అమెరికా ఆర్ ఇండియా అండ్ ఆర్ ఆస్ట్రేలియా ఆర్ ఆఫ్రికా, ఆల్ దీస్ ఆర్ మేనిఫెస్టేషన్స్ ఆఫ్ వన్ డివైన్ ఓన్లీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ హీ సెడ్. దెన్ అట్ ది ఎండ్ హీ సెడ్, వాట్ ఈస్ ఇట్ ఆల్ ఫర్ యూ? యూ ఆర్ నాట్ ఇన్ ద లోవర్ క్లాస్. ఆల్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ ఫర్ ఎ మంద ప్రజ్ఞ, ఫర్ ఎన్ ఆర్డినరీ పర్సన్ హూ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఏబుల్ టు విజువలైజ్ ఎ హయ్యర్ రియాలిటీ. యూ షుడ్ బి ఏబుల్ టు రియలైజ్ ఎ హయ్యర్ రియాలిటీ. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈ సెడ్. అండ్ దెన్ ద నెక్స్ట్ చాప్టర్ వీఆర్ మూవింగ్ టు ఈజ్ వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ విశ్వరూప సందర్శన యోగ. విశ్వరూప సందర్శన యోగ. సో వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ విశ్వరూప? వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ మూవీస్, అఫ్ కోర్స్. ఈవెన్ ఇఫ్ వీ హ్యావ్ నాట్ రెడ్ మహాభారత, వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ మూవీస్. సేన్ మూవీస్ వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్ లార్డ్ కృష్ణ షోయింగ్ హిజ్ విశ్వరూప. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్, వెన్ హీ గోస్ యాజ్ అ మీడియేటర్ టు ద కోర్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది కౌరవస్, దుర్యోధన, దుశ్శాసన, ఎట్సెట్రా ఎట్సెట్రా, దే వాంట్ టు బైండ్ హిమ్. దే వాంట్ టు సే బైండ్ హిమ్, అరెస్ట్ హిమ్ అండ్ దెన్ త్రో హిమ్ సమ్వేర్. సో బట్ దెన్ అట్ దట్ టైమ్ హీ షోస్ హిజ్ విశ్వరూప అండ్ దెన్ ఆల్ ద పీపుల్ దే జస్ట్ ఫాల్ డౌన్ బికాస్ దే కాంట్ ఈవెన్ సీ దట్ బ్రైట్నెస్ అండ్ దెన్ దే ఫాల్ డౌన్, ఎక్సెప్ట్ సమ్ ఎల్డర్లీ పీపుల్ లైక్ భీష్మ, ద్రోణ, ఎట్సెట్రా. దెన్ ఎట్ అనదర్ టైమ్ ఆల్సో హీ గివ్స్ హీ షోస్ దట్ విశ్వరూప. దట్ ఈస్ వెన్ సే ఆల్ ద కింగ్స్ దే రెబెల్ అగెన్స్ట్ హిమ్. ఇన్ దట్ ధర్మరాజాస్ కోర్ట్, ధర్మరాజా వాజ్ పర్ఫార్మింగ్ వన్ రాజసూయ యాగ. వెన్ ధర్మరాజా వాంటెడ్ టు వర్షిప్ కృష్ణ, వాట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ అగ్ర పూజ, హీ వాంటెడ్ టు గివ్ ది ఫస్ట్ పూజ టు లార్డ్ కృష్ణ. దెన్ దుర్యోధన, దుశ్శాసన, ఆల్ ద పీపుల్ దే అబ్జెక్ట్ అండ్ దెన్ శిశుపాల కమ్స్ వెరీ ఫెరోషియస్లీ. అండ్ అట్ దట్ టైమ్ సే ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ కృష్ణ హీ సెండ్స్ హిస్ చక్రం అండ్ దెన్ రిమూవ్స్ హిస్ హెడ్. సో దేర్ ఆఫ్టర్ హీ వెన్ ఆల్ ది సే కింగ్స్ దే రెబెల్ అండ్ దెన్ గో టు హిమ్, అట్ దట్ టైమ్ హీ షోస్ హిస్ విశ్వరూప. సో లైక్ దట్ వీ హ్యావ్ సీన్. సో వీఆర్ ఫెమిలియర్ విత్ దట్ సైట్ వేర్ దట్ యాక్టర్, వెరీ హ్యాండ్సమ్ యాక్టర్, హీ కెన్ బి ఎనీబడి. సో హీ విల్ బి షో, హిజ్ స్టేచర్ విల్ గ్రో, హిజ్ సైజ్ విల్ గ్రో ఇన్ సైజ్ టు ఫిల్ ది ఎంటైర్ స్క్రీన్ అండ్ దెన్ దేర్ ఆర్ సో మెనీ హెడ్స్ షోన్. సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ వీ కాల్ విశ్వరూప. సో వాట్ ఈస్ దిస్ విశ్వరూప యాక్చువల్లీ ఇన్ అవర్ టర్మ్స్? వీఆర్ నాట్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ దట్ విశ్వ, అఫ్ కోర్స్ వీఆర్ రిఫరింగ్ టు దాట్, బట్ దెన్ వాట్ ఈస్ ది రియల్ మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ విశ్వరూప? విశ్వరూప ఈజ్ లీవింగ్ అవర్ నేరో విజన్ ఆఫ్ looking at a small entity as that supreme reality, trying to understand the entire cosmic mind, the entire cosmic scheme as we call it, the entire cosmic mind you call it, the entire scheme of things. So that is what is called Vishwarupa. That is basically training ourselves to see the whole entity, the whole cosmos as an organism. The entire cosmic mind we are seeing as an organism, and in that cosmic mind we are like small ripples. If you imagine a huge, if you imagine the ocean, in that ocean a small wave or a small ripple or a small bubble of water, we are like that. So in that ocean of consciousness, so that is what it is. So we have to see the whole, the integral, we have to see the whole and then we have to look upon ourselves as an integral part of that larger whole. So that is what we have to see. So this cosmic mind, we know that there is a name for that, what we call Hiranyagarbha. Again, to recapitulate, the supreme reality is only called consciousness or supreme Brahman or consciousness. That has got a manifesting power, and once it manifests, the first notion of I, the first notion of self, it is called Hiranyagarbha, that cosmic mind. And in that from that cosmic mind, all our individual minds, they seem to have just fallen apart, like Agneha Vispulinga Iva, one Upanishad says. That is, you have a huge fire, from that huge fire some small sparkles fall out, thousands and thousands of sparkles fall out. So like that, like Vispulinga, all these things have formed. So that is how figuratively it has been described. So anyway, So the approach here is to look at a larger picture. So that is what he see, that is what is Krishna is saying here. Then this particular adhyaya, which the 11th chapter, is a fairly big adhyaya, which is having about 55 verses. It starts with questions of Arjuna, then again Krishna replies, and then Arjuna, he wants to see, because all of us, we have got a curiosity. Our curiosity is like we know the story of Vivekananda. Vivekananda went to Ramakrishna Paramahamsa and then he asked, have you seen God? Then that man said, yes, I have seen God. Can you show him to me? Yes, I can show him to you. So this man was totally perplexed. So that is how their interaction started, and then naturally gradually he started to understand. So when our curiosity, basic curiosity of a human being is to see a thing. To see means what? When I look at an object, what is it I am doing? This object is something which is seen by me, which is known by me, so it is something which is inferior to my mind. If I am able to see the thing called God, then God also is something which is an object. God is something which is inferior to my mind. Knower is always greater than the object which is known. A knower, or the intelligence, the principle of intelligence which is the knower, is always superior to, it belongs to a higher class, let us say. It belongs to a higher class than the object which is an insentient object which is known. So, if I say that God, if I want to visualize God as somebody who is say a million times or 10 million times bigger than Schwarzenegger or something like that, then I am making a huge mistake. But human mind is so trained that we want to see God, we want to say, okay, I have a darshan of God. So that is what is human mind. So it is not that way it is being, which is being told in Vedanta. What Vedanta says is, you cannot objectify that thing, you can only understand it, you can realize that, you can realize that you are not different from that. So that is what it says. Ultimately, it says that you can't be different from that, because that supreme reality is something which is all pervading, it is infinity. If you want to say that you are apart from infinity, there cannot be anything apart from infinity. If you want to say that you are really apart from infinity, you are calling yourself zero, because there cannot be anything apart from infinity. So that is what Vedanta says. So here we can only understand it. You can't see it, but you can understand it, you can become it. Vedanta says, Brahmavit Brahmaiva Bhavati, that is, a person who understands Brahman becomes Brahma. It doesn't mean it is you are as big, you should feel proud about it and then, yes, I am Brahma, etc. It is not like that. When the individual ego is totally gone, when you say, I am Brahman, the individual ego is no longer there. So, when the individual is ego or individual mind is so totally dissolved, then only this man, he is observed by others as a Brahmavit. He can't say, yes, I know Brahman, I can teach you, etc., etc. So, it is not like that. So, here we are seeing that Vishwarupa Darshana Yoga. So, here Arjuna is asking, Madanugrahaya Paramam Guhyam Adhyatma Sangnitam. Here, of course, I will skip some shlokas because just narrative. Because here he says, okay, for my say, in order to bless me, you are being very kind to me, and then you have told all that, and then Mohoyam Vigato Mama, all my delusion is gone, etc., etc. Then you have also told about, say, at length, the origin and dissolution of all the beings, he said. Then evam etad yathartvam atmanam parameshwara drashtumichhami te rupam aishwaram purushottama. This is what is it. I told you, we have got an anxiety, we have got an eagerness to see that supreme whatever God. So that is what he is asking. Then manyase yadi tat shakyam maya drashtumiti prabho Yogeshwara tato me tvam darshayamasa darshayatmanam avyayam. O Yogeshwara, you show me your say real nature. Then Sri Bhagavan Uvacha, Krishna says, yes, okay, now you can see. You can see the entire say cosmos, you can see in me. So that is what he says. Pashya Adityan, Vasun, Rudran, Ashvinav, Marutastatha. All the gods, demigods, whatever, say Bahun, Adushta, Purvani, all things which are there in the universe, you can see in me. And he says, Natumam Shakyase Drashtum, Anenaiva Svachakshusha, Divyam dadami tejakshuhu, pasyame yoga maishwaram. He says, you cannot see with your normal eyes. I am going to give you some divya chakshu. Divya chakshu means a divine vision, let us say. What is this divine vision? So, is it something like a 3D glass or something like that, which you are, when you go to a movie, you have some 3D glass to see a 3D movie? Not like that. The commentators have clearly mentioned that divya chakshu or a divine vision means sukshmatam apaditam manayeva. That is what they say. It is not as though Krishna put his hand on his head and then he said, yes, you are now having a divya drushti, etc. That is not the meaning. The meaning is that the mind has become so purified. The mind has become sukshmata. Sukshma means subtle. The mind has to become so subtle. Only when the mind becomes very subtle, when the mind is free from all the dirt which is always having, because the mind is always filled with so much of dirt. I like a thing, I dislike a thing, raga, that is what is called raga, dvesha. Then again, there are some other various other aspects like anger, fear, so many other emotions. So, these things, they are supposed to be the chitta pala, chitta mala, that is the dirt in the mind. So, sukshmatam apaditam mana means when this mind has become so subtle, very clean, very pure, only then you will be able to see. So, at least temporarily, Krishna has given him that, granted him that particular status. He said, divyam dadami te chakshuhu. In fact, we have to remember that when gods, they want to favor a person, dadami buddhi yogam tam. Lord Krishna himself said earlier, just now, I think in the earlier chapter we completed, dadami buddhi yogam tam. That is, when a devotee comes to me, what I give to him is buddhi, proper intellect. It is not as though Krishna is not saying, I will give him plenty of money, I will give him so much of gold and silver, etc. He is not saying, he is only saying, buddhi yogam, I am going to give him buddhi. So, that is what he says. Here also he says the same, divyam dadami te chakshu pasyame yogam aishwaram. So, it is referring to a trained, disciplined mind. And it is also implying that when Arjuna is able to see, you and I are also able to see, provided we make our minds very pure, very simple. In fact, simple is another word, simple and innocence is another word, because innocence, all the sages and rishis, they are also said to be innocent. So, that is what we see about this Sanaka Sanandanadi story. If you have heard that story, it seems this Sanaka Sanandanadi, there are four sages, Sanaka, Sanandana, Sanat Kumara, another gentleman. So, these four sages, they are extremely, they are great jnanis, and then they are realized persons, and then in that is the stage of innocence. They are like children, it is said, it is described that they are like children, they just move naked. So, it is like that. And once they go, and then that is the story of Jaya Vijaya, we need not go into that. The point is that a learned man, he is also an innocent man. If somebody is innocent, we should not ridicule him. He may be a highly learned man also, because highly learned people, maybe sometimes professors, people like that, because we come across professors and such people, very, very innocent. They are not crooked, and then they are not worldly wise like an ordinary man on the street. An ordinary man on the street may be more crooked, more worldly wise than a great professor. So, we are talking about that sukshmatam apaditam mana, a subtle mind which is able to see bigger things. He is not bothered about the small things. So, anyway, Sanjay, now, divyam dadami te chakshuhu, that is what he says. Then, Sanjaya uvacha, eva muktva tato rajan maha yogeshwareshwarah, because Sanjaya also is able to see, because by the grace of sage Vyasa, in the beginning he was saying, by the grace of sage Vyasa, I could listen to what was the talk which was going on between Arjuna and Krishna. That is what he said. So, he is also able to see that Vishwarupa, though the Kaurava army is not able to see that. Then, what Sanjaya is describing? Sanjaya says, okay, Lord Krishna at that time, he showed his Vishwarupa, which is like this. He is describing in a few, shlokas. Thereafter, of course, Arjuna comes and then Arjuna takes up and then he describes it. Sanjaya is saying, Aneka Vaktranayanam, Aneka Adbhuta Darshanam, Aneka Divyabharanam, Divyanekodhyatayudham. So, this is again the cosmic rupa. As I said, when you are visualizing a cosmic mind, you also visualize a cosmic body. That cosmic mind is called Hiranyagarbha, and the cosmic body, we have to give a name. It is not as though there is a person called Hiranyagarbha. Whenever I say Hiranyagarbha, we should not mistake him for a person. It is an entity, it is a concept. And similarly, this cosmic body is also a concept. Cosmic body, the name given is Virat. Virat means Vividham Rajate iti Virat. That is seen in so many forms. Vividham Rajate. It shines in so many forms. It shines as Indra, it shines as Rudra, it shines as Maruta. So many forms. It shines as, in simple terms, it shines as wind, it shines as thunder, it shines as rain. All these things, they are divine entities, we say. So, like that, Aneka Vaktranayanam, Aneka Adbhuta Darshanam. This Aneka Vaktranayanam, in fact, I was referring to what is called Purusha Sukta. When you go to temples, you listen to this Purusha Sukta, Sahasra Shirusha Purusha, Sahasra Akshas, Sahasrapath, etc., etc. So, that is that Virat Purusha with thousands and thousands of heads, innumerable, countless or infinite number of heads. Where are these heads from? All our heads only are there. It is not as though he is a separate being and then we are separate. Your head and my head are also part and parcel of that Virat Purusha's heads only. Sahasra Shirusha Purusha, when we say that, your head and my head and head of an ant, the head of a mosquito, the head of some snake, the head of a dog, all these things. Head means what? Representing intelligence, representing the brain, representing the mind and intelligence. The intelligence which is reflecting in that particular antahkarana, that is what is the meaning of Shirsha. Sahasra Shirsha means all these antahkaranas, which are there right from a, say, let us say an amoeba, right from a sort of a virus, even that also has got an intelligence, because that also knows how to cope with our medicines. So, which means there is intelligence in that also. So, all these things, that is the Sahasra Shirsha. So, that is what he is saying, Aneka Vaktranayanam, Aneka Adbhuta Darshanam, etc., etc. And in this way, Sanjaya describes, then he says, Tatraikastham jagatkrutsanam pravibhaktam anekadha apashyat devadevasya sharire pandavastada. So, Arjuna saw that huge figure at that time. That is what he says. Then Arjuna becomes vismayavishtaha. That is, he is vismayavishtaha, means he is totally filled with wonder, and his hair, all the hair on the body, it is bristling, the hair is standing on end or bristling. And then he bent his head down, and then he started saying, Pashyami, Arjuna uvacha, Arjuna is saying, Pashyami devanstava deva dehe sarvanstatha bhuta vishesha sanghan. I am able to see all the people in you, Brahman, Amisham, Kamalasanastham. I am able to see Brahma, I am able to see Rudra, I am able to see Kamalasanastham, that is Brahma. All these people I am able to see. What does it mean? That means that Srushti, Sthiti, Laya, all the things are shown in a figurative way. It is not as though somebody is creating something, somebody is swallowing something, it is not like that. He is in a very figurative way, he is saying that Srushti, Sthiti, Laya, the entire thing is shown there. And in particular, that Laya aspect it is going to be emphasized now. That Laya aspect also is going to be told. Then he says, Aneka Bahudara Vaktranetram Pashyamitvam Sarvato Anantarupam. That is, I am able to see so many shoulders, Bahu, Udara, Vaktra, Netra. That means, all the limbs of all the beings on earth, not only earth, in the universe, let us say. All the limbs of all the beings in the universe, they belong to you. That is how we have to see. It is not as though there is somebody who is a person who is different from us, and then we are different from that. Then kiritinam gadinam chakrinam cha, there is some description about, he is having so many kiritas, etc., etc. And then Arjuna, from that level, he slightly slowly graduates to a higher level. He is able to see that oneness in all things. The basic idea is to see oneness in all things. So he says, tvam aksharam paramam veditavyam. Earlier he was referring to him as a person. I am looking at you as a person. Now he says, tvam aksharam paramam veditavyam. Veditavyam aksharam. He has gone to neuter gender. Earlier he was addressing him in masculine gender. Now he is addressing in neuter gender. That is the supreme reality, which is neither man nor female or anything. It is in the neuter gender, pure entity. So, Tvam Aksharam Paramam Veditavyam, Tvamasya Vishvasya Param Nidhanam. So, I am seeing you as the substratum for all the things which we are able to, which we are seeing here. So, whatever Bheda Drushti, whatever that dualistic vision, that I am different and something else is different, that dualistic vision has gone. And then he is gradually seeing a big picture. He is able to see, say, the nature of the divine, or nature of oneness, let us say. He is able to see that oneness in all the things. And then he says, Tvam avyayaha shashvata dharma gopta. You are the person who, say, protector, shashvata dharma gopta. This is again a very important word. That is, you are the protector of that eternal order, shashvata dharma, that eternal order. There is an eternal order. That is, what we call it as, yada yada hi dharma se, etc. For example, whenever there is a rise in, there is a disequilibrium in the gunas, there is again a manifestation in order to bring about some equilibrium. So, that is what we have seen in fourth chapter and earlier chapters. So, shashvata dharma gopta, the person who maintains that eternal order, then he describes like that, anadi madhyantam ananta viryam ananta bahum shashi surya netram, etc., etc., he says. Then he goes on like that. Amihitvam surasangha vishanti keshit bhita pranjalayo grunanti. He says, all these hosts of these devas, all the devas, they are all singing praises of you. And then there are some other bad people who are afraid of you and running away from you. And then all these rishis, sages, munis, etc., they are praising you. So, he is describing all types of, three types of people, the gods, the humans and rakshasas. The rakshasas who are running away from you and then trying to run away, because those people are also getting eaten by this picture, by this figure. Then he says, Rudra, Aditya, Vasavo, Yecha, Sadhyaha. All these forms, various divine forms, whether you call it Rudra or Aditya or Vasu, all these divine forms, they are all, I am able to see in that. Then I am skipping some shlokas because this description is there for a long, long time. Then an important point is, he is now seeing that Vishwarupa as a very, very fierce figure, where all the enemies, they are also getting sucked in that huge mouths. Arjuna is able to see that huge, in that Vishwarupa, huge mouth, which say for example, Damstra Karala Nichate Mukhani. So, fearful with blazing tusks, like elephant-like tusks. So, that such damstra karala anichate mukhani, drushtvaiva kalanala sannibhani, something like pralaya fires. They are like that fires of say damnation. And then, I am not able to just know where I am. And then, amichatvam dhrutarashtrasya putraha. So, all these sons of this dhrutarashtra, all these enemy forces, he is able to see. Not only enemy forces, his people also, they are all, it is like, say, we have seen in that movie, so that Maya Bazaar or some such movie where he sits and then all the food goes into his mouth. So, like that, all these enemy forces like Dhritarashtra, Duryodhana, Dushyasana, etc., etc., all these people, they are just running into your mouth, he says, they are running into your mouth. It is not as though you are sucking them, they are running into your mouth. Sahaiva Avanipala Sanghaihi. Bhishmo, Dronaha, Sutaputras, Tathasaus, Saha, Smadiyairapi Yodha Mukhyehi, even along with our own people, not as though our people are left out, our people are also running into that. Vaktranite, Tvaramana, Vishanti, they are just running into your mouth, Damstrakara, Anicha, Bhayanakani, and then some people are seen stuck between your teeth, and then they are being crushed by your teeth, Churinitaihi, Uttamangaihi, their heads are being crushed by your teeth. Though we are not supposed to think that God is such a very, very fierce figure. He is only talking about the function called laya. There is what is called srushti, sthiti, laya, that resolution. Anything which is born, it will come to an end. So, that particular laya is being showed, that laya is not a negative thing. That laya takes place only for recreation. So, for further creation, let us say, not recreation, but further creation. So, this laya is not a negative thing. And then all this is being figuratively shown, only figuratively it is being said that all these people are, their heads are crushed, etc., etc. So, this is mentioned basically to say that what the Vishwarupa which Krishna is showing here is something which is something where this laya is emphasized more. He is not talking about other things, because the message which has to go to Arjuna is that you are a small entity. You are only a cog in that whole wheel. he is going to say, you are merely a cog in that entire wheel, he say, and then even without you, this is going to all these people are going to say, come into my mouth. So that is what he is going to say. So that is how this adhyaya is going to an end. I think we will complete this adhyaya in the next episode. Only a few verses are there. We will complete it in the next episode. Harihi Om Tat Sat.